Welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Dr. Amrit G. Kumar. I am working as Associate Professor in the Department of Education of Central University of Kerala. Today, we will have discussion about brief history of educational laws and policies in India. The framers of Indian Constitution recognize the immense importance of elementary education. At the same time, they perceived a lot of challenges in making elementary education a constitutional right. Article 45 of Indian Constitution states that the state shall endeavor to provide within a period of 10 years from the commencement of this constitution for free and compulsory education for all children until they complete the age of 14 years. The Article 45 of Indian Constitution, shows the commitment of our constitutional builders towards free and compulsory education of all the children in India. The importance of free and compulsory education was highlighted by this particular article number 45. The commitment towards universalization of primary education was again made in the National Policy of Education 1968 and also National Policy on Education in 1986 and the Program of Action in continuation to the National Policy on Education of 1986, which was framed in 1992. In all these national policies, the universalization of primary education was an important agenda. Schemes and programs for the attainment of universalization of elementary education is a best example for our nation's commitment towards universalization of primary education. Operation Blackboard is an important one in this respect. Operation Blackboard is an attempt to improve the basic infrastructure available within the primary school system or elementary schools. All kinds of infrastructures were being addressed by Operation Blackboard. Then non-formal education was another important initiative by the government for improving universalization of education. Teacher education programs at various levels and various policies to improve teacher education program was another important commitment from the part of the government of India since independence to improve the quality and to ensure universalization of elementary education. Mahila Samakhya, state-specific education projects like the one which was introduced by Andhra Pradesh Primary Education Project and Bihar Education Project, Lok Jumpish Education Project in Rajasthan, Education for All Project in Uttar Pradesh, Shiksha Kami Project in Rajasthan, National Program of Nutritional Support to Primary Education, District Primary Education Program. All these are various programs initiated by the central government as well as different state governments to improve the universalization of elementary education. The basic purpose of many of these projects was to increase the enrollment of our students, of our children belonging to 6 to 14 years of age, and thereby bringing them all into the schools and to provide them quality education at least at elementary level. Some of the programs which I have mentioned just now are basically looking into improving the quality of the elementary education. Hence, we can see that increasing enrollment and increasing quality of education at elementary level was an important agenda of our government, both central and state governments at various times, and still it continues to be. National Policy on Education in 1986 initiated the goal of universalization of elementary education, and programs such as different states sponsored programs which I have just mentioned, the one which was introduced by Andhra Pradesh government, then Bihar government, Rajasthan government, and so on, where strong support for launching our initiatives for the universalization of elementary education. DPEP and subsequently, DPEP means District Primary Education Program, and subsequently Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan were implemented as one of the India's flagship programs for universalization of elementary education. Programs like DPEP was introduced with the support of the World Bank. And that means that the initiatives of the government of India to attain universalization of elementary education has received international attention and support as well. So DPEP and SSA can be considered as the two gigantic projects which was introduced in India for improving universalization of elementary education. In a landmark judgment in 1993, the Supreme Court said, every child has the right to free education until he or she completes the age of 14 years. So this was a landmark decision or verdict from the part of the Supreme Court. In continuation to that, during 1998, the education ministers of various states in a meeting convened by the central government resolved to say that universal education should be pursued in the mission mode. In pursuance of this, in 2001, the government of India launched the prestigious scheme Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is a government of India's flagship program for achievement of universalization of elementary education in a time-bound manner. The Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is an effort to universalize elementary education in association with community ownership, or the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is an effort to universalize elementary education by community ownership of the school system. This is a very important policy which was introduced as part of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. We cannot educate our children or to attain universalization of elementary education by keeping our community away from the process of education. Realizing this, the importance of community in educating the children, community ownership of school system has become an important criterion, an important feature of universalization of elementary education, which was introduced by Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Thus, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is a partnership between central, state and local government. In 2002, the 86th Amendment to the Constitution was passed. The 86th Amendment of Indian Constitution reads that the state shall provide free and compulsory education to all children of the age 6 to 14 years in such a manner as the state may by law determine. To give effect to the amendment, the right to education was passed by the Parliament in 2009. The Act came into force from 1st April 2010. As we have seen, the 86th Amendment says that education will become a free, education is a fundamental right and it should be provided free and compulsorily to all the children belonging to the age group of 6 and 14. But the same 86th Amendment has made it mandatory that the government should pass an act to make the Right to Education Bill or the 86th Amendment executed through a Parliament Bill. And this has happened only in the year 2009. And hence when we passed the Right to Education Bill in 2009 in the Parliament, the Act came into force, and thereby the Right to Education Act came into force from 1st April 2010 onwards. Let us conclude the previous slides or the discussion that we have made today. The various educational laws and policies were launched for the improvement of education in India. Since from independence, we have seen that a large number of schemes and policies were introduced specifically for improving enrollment and improving the quality of primary education and thereby achieving universalization of elementary education in India. And these policies and schemes included various central government policies and schemes, as well as the schemes and policies introduced by different state governments. National Policies of Education in 1968 and 1986, and the Program of Action of the National Policy of Education in 1992 was committed towards universalization of primary education. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan and DPEP with the support of World Bank and Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan were two other major important initiatives from the central government to attain universalization of elementary education. So with this, we conclude our discussion about various laws and policies in education to improve elementary education. Thank you.